We've discovered gravitational waves again. And guess what caused this ripple in spacetime? Yes, more colliding black holes. Hi there, spacetime entities. Ian here for DNews on a very, very big day for physics. Since the discovery of gravitational waves hit the headlines back in February, we've been patiently waiting to see whether or not it was a fluke. And I can tell you now, it wasn't. The LIGO Project has detected these ripples in spacetime again. It's hard to put into words just how momentous the first historic discovery of gravitational waves was for science. A little over 100 years ago, Albert Einstein predicted their existence, but it wasn't until the ultra-sensitive laser interferometer gravitational wave observatory, or advanced LIGO, went online that we stood a chance of detecting them. Gravitational waves are basically ripples through spacetime, traveling at the speed of light. If you imagine ripples traveling across the surface of a pond after dropping a pebble into the water, you have a pretty good two-dimensional view about what's going on. But to detect three-dimensional gravitational waves passing through Earth, and therefore passing through us, we need a very, very sensitive detector. This is where LIGO comes in. The project consists of two observing stations, basically two L-shaped buildings with 2.5 mile long tunnels, one in Washington and one in Louisiana, nearly 2,000 miles apart. Two stations are needed to confirm the presence of a gravitational wave signal and tell us which direction it's traveling in. And that's what happened on December 26, 2015. A second spacetime chirp was detected. Really, when converted into an audio representation, gravitational waves sound like a chirp. Listen. Through analysis, LIGO physicists were able to deduce that the first LIGO chirp in September 2015 was caused by a black hole merger. That first famous signal was generated by two black holes, one 29 times the mass of the Sun and one 36 times the mass of our Sun, getting trapped in a gravitational spiral, eventually colliding and creating one large black hole. So that chirp is the cataclysmic collision of two black holes some 1.3 billion light years away. The most recent event, called GW151226, that has just been announced today, was caused by two smaller black holes, one 14 solar masses and one only 8 solar masses. But when they merged, they created one spinning black hole of 21 solar masses. Now you may think my math is off. Surely 14 plus 8 equals 22. Where did that one solar mass go? Well, during the collision, which happened 1.4 billion light years away, one whole solar mass of material was converted directly from matter into energy, and that energy is what created the powerful gravitational waves that literally shook spacetime. That's cool, right? But there's more. Because LIGO is two observing stations, we can roughly work out where this black hole merger occurred in the sky. Check out this map of the general region of the sky where LIGO thinks these two black hole mergers occurred. In a statement, Caltech's Albert Lazzarini, the deputy director of LIGO, said, LIGO is bringing us a new way to observe some of the darkest yet most energetic events in our universe. And he's not wrong. We are seeing a revolution in astronomy. For the first time, we can hear the passage of gravitational waves from violent events that occurred billions of years ago and deduce what caused them. Now there are plans for more gravitational wave detectors to go online soon, including the European Virgo project, so we can better understand how many black holes there are in our universe and pinpoint where these amazing black hole mergers are happening. The discovery of gravitational waves sent ripples through spacetime and humanity. Check out Julia's video about the first historic detection of gravitational waves.
The theory goes that two black holes will circle each other and lose energy that's released as gravitational waves. Over time, they will get closer and closer over the course of a few billion years, then finally collide in a fraction of a second. This releases a large amount of mass as energy in the form of gravitational waves.
Are you as excited as me about seeing black holes collide? Tell us in the comment section down below, and don't forget to click subscribe for new episodes every day. I'll see you next time on DNews.